So I'm really excited to show off some of what we've been working on this new project at baseten called Blueprint. So maybe just stepping back before diving into the details of this web IDE thing that you can see is, as we all know, there have been a ton of these crazy cool language models and text to image models that have been released in the last even just 6 months. And there's been a lot of interest across the internet, like every day you go on Twitter, for people who want to create applications using these new models. So what we've done here is we've created this little product called Blueprint that solves this main problem, which is you have 6 hours on a Saturday to try playing around with one of these language models. In order to actually create an application using it, you need to do this whole dev setup process. It's really annoying. You don't want to have to spend that 6 hours you have on a Saturday, spending half of it, getting a Django app started. So the problem that the way we've sort of addressed that is by having a really easy way to just write code and have that be available on the web. So I'm going to just do a quick walkthrough of what you have here. So in Blueprint, you have this list of projects. You can just click on one of them to jump into a project. And you have two things here in your project page. So on the right, you can see that we have this console. In this console, we can, we have a few of these models that I just talked about that are available to play around with. I'm just going to show off one of them, which is this model called FLAN T5. This is a text model. And so with my FLAN T5 model, so this is, I'm going through how I would, play around this. This is just like a normal Python shell. I can create this model and then call it with a prompt. So with FLAN T5, I think one of the really effective things that it can do is, so it's a text model like GPT, but much cheaper to use. It's really good for tasks like summarization. I'm going to use it for sentiment analysis. So if I just want to say, what is the sentiment of this text? I hate this restaurant. All right, I'm gonna hit enter and it says negative. Awesome, pretty fast. Cool. So in this console, you can mess around with things. Now, let's say I want an API endpoint that I can hit from, a JavaScript app. Let's say on the side, I have an app that I've made with Vercel, and I just want to have an API endpoint where I can call this new sentiment analysis API effectively. All right, so we can jump into this route section. So all routes are just Python functions that allow you to add this decorator called @route to a function. And what adding this @route decorator does is turns this function into an API endpoint that you can then call. I'm just going to demo this real quick. So, you can see here that this myRoute function takes a single argument called request. This is a object that allows you to get query parameters out. So if I just want to have an API with a single query parameter called text, I can extract it like this. And I'm going to do one of those cooking videos where it just skips ahead to the final version of this, because we all know how live demos go. What I've done is I've defined this function where we take the request and get a parameter called query out of it, and I'm just passing it into FLAN T5 and asking what the sentiment is and versioning the result. There's this little playground where you can play around with, I'm going to save this, and where you can play around with the different routes that you've made. So this is called my route. So I'm just going to do a get request. I've called my query. So here I can say query is, I hate this restaurant. Send it. I excluded an import. Save. All right, let's try this again. And boom, negative. Cool. So now I effectively have I'm just going to call it, I'm going to change it from my route to sentiment analysis. And, you know, now I have this sentiment analysis API that I can use in a lot of different contexts because it's just an API endpoint. So let's do that again. And I'm going to show off one more thing, which is, so here I can say, you know, again, query is, I love this restaurant. Cool, positive. Now I can, you know, we have the ability to copy this this URL to curl it. I'm just going to show this in the browser just because I'm already presenting here. But I can call this, you know, all this is now just an API endpoint that you can call and get results back. And I can change this to, you know, whatever I want, you know, the fries at this restaurant were soggy. Negative. Cool. We also support Stable Diffusion at Whisper, two other really cool language models to very quickly, again, like make API endpoints, call them from your JavaScript app or, you know, wherever you want to call them, and without the hassle of having to do the dev setup and create a backend. More to come.